Good evening. First tonight, the Prime Minister's announced a $64 million task force to crack down on gangs, with 70 officers on the trail of organised crime. But Tony Abbott, like Julia Gillard, is trying to win key votes in a key election battleground and has already slammed the plan. For more, we're joined now by political editor Hugh Wimmington, who's travelling with the Prime Minister. Hugh, is this task force just all about Labor trying to claw back crucial support in Western Sydney?
Well, Tash, gun crime, drive-by shootings, criminal gangs, these certainly are big issues in Western Sydney. But the rest of the nation is not immune to the effects either, some places more than others. The Prime Minister has been at pains to stress that today. She says the idea came from the Federal Police Commissioner, Tony Negus. The idea really is about getting much smarter at following the money so that they can break up organised crime. Up early, and yes, in Western Sydney, Tony Abbott on Clean Up Australia duty.
This is a terrific Australian crowd that's been here today, fully reflective of the face of modern multicultural Australia.
The Prime Minister is trying to clean up crime, announcing money for a new task force to target criminal gangs and the trade in drugs and guns.
We are seeing more sophistication by criminals. It's got to be met by more sophistication by us.
It's about state and federal law enforcement agencies working together to target criminals, arrest them, and seize their assets.
It sounds very much like something that the coalition proposed at the last election.
The latest gangland shooting in Victoria proof the issues go well beyond Western Sydney.
This is about a national plan and bringing new national resources to make a difference.
In the last 5 years, drug seizures have doubled as the focus has shifted from physical searches to criminal intelligence. But as senior federal sources told 10 News, our ports especially are riddled with career criminals or people in their pay.
They've actually cut more than $250 million out of the AFP.
Not true, says our top federal cop.
In the last 5 years, I think our budget's gone up around $300 million.
The Prime Minister's five-day blitz in Western Sydney is now underway. One local Labor MP already seems resigned, though, to bad news come September.
My old man lost jobs all the way through the 80s and 90s out in Western Sydney. And, you know, if you do, you do. You just got to pick yourself up and move on.
And he's on a 12% margin. Well, Labor's fight back for Western Sydney, where the election could effectively be won and lost come September. It starts here tonight with the Prime Minister giving a speech in the Parramatta campus of the University of Western Sydney. She's going to promise in the speech a five-point plan for Western Sydney, and basically it amounts to jobs, broadband, school education, disability and healthcare, and what she calls helping people manage the pressures of modern life. It is a big and broad agenda. Tash, we'll see if it works.
Absolutely. A long election campaign ahead. Thank you, Hugh.